Hi friends, in this video we will discuss the convolution integral. That means the concept of getting the output for an LTA system if the input signal is available and the impulse response of the system is available, then the output is called convolution sum if the system is discrete time system. Obviously the input is discrete time signal. Similarly, for a continuous time system and for a continuous time signal, the output should be the convolution integral of both of them. Okay, let us discuss this convolution integral in detail in this video. So the weighted superposition is termed as convolution integral for continuous time systems. So this is the weighted superposition. So just what we have discussed in convolution sum for a discrete time system, here we need to see the convolution integral, because here the signal is continuous in nature, so we can't add for each and every point. Instead we can do the integration, so definitely we need to go ahead with the integration only. So this is the convolution integral for continuous time system. So how this can be done? This is very simple. X of t is equal to integral of minus infinity to infinity x of tau delta t minus tau d tau. So this is the simple equation. This is representing this input signal in terms of impulse response. Now we need to use this impulse response for the output of the system. Okay, let us see. This is obviously the shifting property of impulses. So what we have seen in the previous video, that is for convolution sum and this is for convolution integral. So how input signal is represented as the shifting property of the impulses. So for each and every point it is shifted, so that those points are from minus infinity to minus infinity, and that is for integral. That means for every small points it is common. Here also we need to use H operator. Let us see. Obviously Y of t is equal to capital H of X of t, and how this H operator will be operated. Let us see. So definitely I need to substitute X of t, that is equal to integral of minus infinity to infinity X tau delta t minus tau. Obviously d tau. So this is the substitution of X of t. So X of t is the input signal represented in terms of shifted impulses. So that will be like this, and by linearity property we need to interchange the operators, integration and also H operator. This is the concept. Again by linearity principle only we need to interchange X of tau and H. So that will be like this. Okay, now we need to define capital H of delta t minus tau is equal to small h of t minus tau. That comes because of the time invariant property. So how much it is shifted as an input signal, so that much we need to shift as a output signal. So this will be substituted here, and finally this is the answer. Integral minus infinity to infinity x of tau h of t minus tau d tau. The above equation is called convolution integral and is denoted by star. Okay, so this is the final expression of convolution integral. So y of t is equal to x of t star h of t is equal to integral of minus infinity to infinity x of tau h of t minus tau d tau. So it's very simple concept. So obviously here x of tau is there and h of t minus tau is there. X of tau is the input signal and h of t minus tau is the impulse response, of course, time shifted impulse response of the system. So it's a continuous system. So this is all about convolution integral, and let's move on to the problems in the next video. Thank you so much for your careful listening. Please like this video and please share this video with your friends. friends and family, and please do subscribe to my YouTube channel if you haven't done so, and kindly press the bell button so that you will get the notifications whenever I upload any video. So I thought of doing some problems on these topics, convolution sum and convolution integral. So please try to be in touch by subscribing my channel and pressing the bell button. Thank you, and thank you so much.